Dr. Jewel Williams, Tri Production Publishing, here with you with our tip number 5. Are you a writer or a waiter? I saw a quote that said, writers write and those that wait are waiters. I thought it was kind of cute. The point was, you can't really call yourself a writer if you're not about the business of writing. So what are some of the hindrances of writing? Let me give you my 3 points for this video. First of all, many say not enough time. You know, I have heard this often. I think many of you are looking at this all wrong. You don't have to sit down and complete an entire book in one sitting. That can be overwhelming when you have this mindset that you have to get all of this done in a short period of time. The key is, if this is important to you, you're going to make the time. You have to make the time to write. Start with, for example, one day a week. Set a time. When are you going to sit down and write, and how long will you write? And then set a goal. You can write 1 page, 2 pages, 3 pages. You determine on how many pages you want to write. And you do that, and then you do that consistently. So when you come to the end of the month, if your goal was just 2 pages once a week, you've got at least 8 pages. Now, for somebody listening, they may say, that doesn't sound like a lot. Well, can I tell you? It beats zero. It's more than zero. If you don't do it, you have nothing. You have to make a plan and then start. The point is, start somewhere. So not enough time. Second point I want to make that I hear is, I can't get my thoughts together. I highly recommend, in fact, I insist on those that I coach that you write an outline. It takes some time to get it together until you're comfortable doing it, but it saves so much time on the back end. You use your outline to form each chapter of your book. And I learned this trick when I was in school writing papers. And so I would create my outline, and sometimes it can get overwhelming because that sometimes takes a lot of time because you want to figure out what your thoughts are. Sometimes I would write my intro. Sometimes I would write my intro and my conclusion and then the outlines and use that as my template. But whatever I would do is, if I was going to use resources, for example, or you need sources, I would, because I knew exactly what I wanted in each chapter, I would set up my references. So for example, if you're using scripture, if you're using other sources, and I would mark, you know, you could put it on an index card, you could do a sticky note and say, this is going to be in chapter 3. And you stack those things. So guess what? You don't have to keep looking through all of this stuff over and over again. You can go to your pile that's for chapter 1 and you can look through that. And then when you sit and write, you've just got your stuff there. You can flow. You don't have to keep stopping to go get your work. And so you just want to take the time to get your thoughts together by doing an outline. I think that's very helpful. And I think a coach would also help you in getting that outline formed successfully. And that's something that I help my writers do. The third point is, someone's already wrote what I want to write about. So that's why, you know, some people don't write. Well, if people stop writing books, articles, blogs, or anything else because someone else has written about that topic, we would have stopped writing years ago, years and years ago. So yes, we don't want to duplicate what others have already said. But this is what's great about writing. You aren't someone else. You're unique. You have your own ideas, your own experiences and thoughts that you can add, put your own spin on that particular topic, even if it's an old topic, write from your perspective. In fact, I would even say, if you see someone else has written about the topic, go and get them as reference to say, hey, this is my point. Arthur B. said this, Arthur C. said that, and together we've come up with this fuller understanding. Because to be honest, that's, you know, that's what you do in research. When I wrote my dissertation, you're not necessarily coming up with new writing. You're building on what's already been written. You're just adding a new perspective. And so what's the 3 points around, are you a writer or a waiter? If you want to be a writer, stop using the excuse that you don't have enough time. Sit down and write, even if it's one day a week, for an hour, 2 hours. Set the timer, close the doors, turn off your phone, and don't stop writing until you finish. The next one, I can't get my thoughts together. Well, that's where an outline will come in. And if you need help with that, I'm the coach to help you with that. Oh, and the last one is, someone's already wrote this, so I don't want to write it. That's not a good enough excuse. You are different. You're unique. Bring your perspective to that article, that book, or whatever it is you want to write. You need a coach and are ready to write your book, come to me, Dr. Jewel Williams of Tri Production Publishing, and we will help you. For more details, you can go to my website, publishthevision.com. Until next time, keep writing.